Depot here, and welcome to the first episode of our reef tank pest control video series. Today we're going to be talking about those pesky little anemones, Aiptasia. Aiptasia are extremely hardy anemones that typically enter your aquarium as a hitchhiker on live rock and coral fragments. In addition to being able to live through terrible conditions, these cnidarians are extremely prolific and pack a gnarly sting that poses a serious threat to the animals inside your tank. It is best to attack Aiptasia at first sight inside your tank, so be sure to know what to look for. They start out small and will emerge from holes and crevices in your rocks and can grow up to 2 to 3 inches in length. They are semi-transparent and generally some hue of brown in color, with long pointy tentacles. The tentacles are the best way to be sure you're looking at Aiptasia and not the often confused Majano anemone, which has shorter tentacles with bulbous tips. The first line of defense for small infestations would be one of the various chemical remedies or the handy Aiptasia and Majano wand. We stock a variety of different chemicals that promise to rid your tank of Aiptasia. Red Sea Aiptasia-X treatment and Joe's Juice Aiptasia Eliminator being two of the best-selling brands. Regardless of the brand, all these chemical treatments work on the same principle of covering or injecting a paste-like solution directly onto the anemone to kill it. It will often take multiple applications to fully kill the Aiptasia, and administering the solution can be a bit frustrating only because the Aiptasia are sensitive and will quickly retract when agitated, making it difficult to apply the medication. I have found that moving precisely and quickly is the only way to hit them with accuracy. The Majano Wand is a unique little device that uses a mild electrical emission from a tiny steel probe. When placed in your tank and used correctly, a reaction occurs at the probe tip that will essentially disintegrate the living tissue of the anemone. Simply poke the target nem, hit the button, and watch the anemone waste away. Repeated removal sessions are often necessary, and be careful to only target a few anemones at a time. I have noticed that using the Majano wand to kill off large numbers of anemones at one time will irritate your tank inhabitants. A few natural predators can also be a great way to help prevent and rid your tank of Aiptasia, especially in situations where the outbreak is substantial. Peppermint shrimp, Aiptasia-eating filefish, copper band butterfly fish, and Bergia nudibranchs are all excellent ways to naturally eliminate Aiptasia. Bergia nudibranchs are my favorite because they prey exclusively on Aiptasia, so you can be sure they will make quick work of the anemones inside your tank. Jeff over at reeftown.com breeds Bergia nudibranchs for Aiptasia control in reef tanks and is one of the few sources in the US. I highly recommend you check out his website if you're in the market for some healthy nudibranchs. He has a load of useful information on how to get the best results from your Bergia and will even help you establish a breeding colony of your own. As of late, some hobbyists are experimenting with high-powered lasers to effectively kill Aiptasia, but this can be a little risky. In addition to being dangerous, we do not have any lasers that are specifically made for aquariums, and repeat application is still required because if you do not burn the entire anemone, including the foot, it will quickly grow back. The foot is often buried deep inside a rock crevice or crack, making it difficult to hit with a concentrated ray of light. Be sure to check out the Marine Depot blog and Education Center for additional articles all about pest control inside your reef tank, and we included a few helpful links in the video description below. We do have plans to create a number of additional videos in this series, and each video will be focused on a specific reef tank pest, so be sure to subscribe to our channel to stay up to date with all of the latest Marine Depot videos. I appreciate all of you for tuning in, and until next time, take care and happy reef keeping.